So hello guys, welcome to HS Academy. In today's video, we are going to learn about confined space and its hazards as well as the safety. Okay, so first of all, we need to understand what is the meaning of a confined space. So confined space is a space which is not designed for continuous working occupancy. It means you cannot continuously work inside that. Yeah, it may be like 50 minutes, 60 minutes you can work by the use of external support, but it is not designed for continuous. If you want to stay here, if you want to continuously work here over 8 hours, 6 hours, it is not possible. Okay, so that will be called as confined space, which is not designed for continuous working occupancy, or you can say that which have limited number of entry and exit. Okay, so for example, I'll give you some example of the confined space, like a storage tank. Okay, in your home, there will be one storage tank. Above your home, there will be one storage tank on the terrace. It is also called a confined space because there will be only one point to go inside that confined space as well as one point to come outside from that confined space. It is one of the example of that. Now, secondary, you come to the process vessels in the refineries as well as in the chemical plants. As you know that a lot of vessels are available, they will also called a confined space because only limited number of entry is present and limited number of exit is present. Okay. Now guys, what are the types of confined space? It means in how many types we can divide the confined space. Basically, there are two major types of confined space available. Okay, first is partially closed and second is fully closed. What is that? Partially closed and second is fully closed. Now, partially closed in the sense, guys, this particular confined space will be having two opening at the sides. Okay, the best example for partially closed confined space will be your pipelines as well as you can say tunnels. Okay, these are also called confined space. If they are very long and no ventilation sources are provided in that, they can prove as a confined space. Okay, the best example for a partially closed confined space can be your penstock. Penstock in the sense when we have seen a hydroelectric power plant, no? So there will be one way from upper level to the lower level by which the water is being transferred. So that is also called a confined space, penstock. You can search it on Google. Okay, now when we come to the fully closed confined space, these are the previous one which I have described you. Okay, so two types of confined space is there, partially closed and fully closed. Okay, now guys, when we talk about the hazards, it means what are the different types of hazards which is present in a confined space. So they are varies. Actually, this particular hazard will depend upon previously what you have stored inside your confined space. For example, within a agro industry, okay, where you have stored a lot of grains, so there will be dust hazard available automatically. Okay, for example, if some industry is there, chemical refinery, where you have stored flammable product previously, so automatically there will be some sort of fire and explosion hazards will be there. Okay, but in generally, if I talk to you what are the different types of hazard, most common hazards which is present inside that is your fires and explosion, engulfment in the sense when you are standing on a loose material, for example a confined space which is filled up of loose material and you are standing on that. Okay, so you will be submerged inside that. What is that? Submerged. Okay, you will be go inside that, totally mix inside that. Okay, second is your engulfment, third is your oxygen deficiency and enrichment, fourth can be your biological organisms like snakes, cockroaches and other biological organisms, scorpions, which can cause you harm. Okay, after that, next electric hazards, after that environmental hazards like no presence of electricity as well as different high temperature and all. Okay, eighth one will be your free flow of solids and liquid. For example, when you are working simply and suddenly the inlet pipes which is coming inside, the pressure vessel will start throwing the material inside, and that time also it is going to be very dangerous for you. Ninth one will be your dust explosion. Okay, and after that will be your toxic and flammable gases present inside the confined space. These are the very common hazards which is present in a confined space. Okay, but now when we talk about the safety of this confined space, so this will accordingly vary what type of hazards which will present. But in general, what are the safety that you need to follow in a confined space? It is like, first of all, when you are giving the entry to the person, those who are going to work inside the confined space, first of all, you need to check out the oxygen level over there. Okay, if oxygen is sufficient, then only you need to allow them. Secondary is whenever you are giving them permit. Okay, so at the time you need to make sure that no toxic gases are present, and whatever the flammable gases are present, they should be below the LEL or above the UEL. Okay, they should not be in the flammable range, because if they are, they can pose a very high risk hazard of a fire and explosion. Okay, as well as if they are in between of LEL and UEL, you can just dilute them by the use of various ventilation systems. third, when we come to the, it is with regards to the rescue measures. Okay, if something happened during carrying out the work inside the confined space, what are the rescue measures that we can implement? Like installation of tripod, rescue team availability, okay, confined space attendant. So these type of things we can do. Next is with regards to issuing of a work permit, confined space work permit. So make sure that whenever you are entering into a confined space, you should have a valid permit for the confined space entry. Okay, next is with regards to the availability of a confined space attendant. It means the person will stand in front of a confined space and will check all the activity. It means whether everything going on fine or not. Okay, next is your with regards to lighting. Whatever the lighting you are taking inside a confined space, make sure that it is meeting with the criteria. Because if that particular light produce any sort of spark, means it can relate to a lot of problems. Okay, so these are the guys, some of the basic safety precaution that you can implement in the confined space, as well as I hope you understood what is the meaning of confined space, its type, its hazards, as well as in the safety. Okay, so this is the full analysis of this topic. If you like this video, press the like button as well as share with your friends, as well as whatever the doubts remaining you have with regards to confined space, please drop in the comment box. I'll be happy to answer you. So thank you for watching. Meet you in the next video. Till then, take care, guys.